next to you, you are in the right place. Come on, tell them if you believe it, you are in the right place and you'll get the right result. Today in Jesus' name. Amen. To minister to us this morning in this first service, I came with a young minister. She's an evangelist. She's a singer. She even produced an album. But above all, I know that she's going to bless you. And because of our time this morning, I want to welcome Anne Gadvidia. Please appreciate her. Come on, do it better. Do it better one more time.
Power of the Lord came upon Elijah, and as he saw the angel fell, he ran I want you to give somebody a high five as you sit down and tell them the overtaking anointing is coming upon you. Please do it better. Tell them the overtaking anointing is coming upon you. And how many believe this morning that the overtaking anointing is coming upon them in Jesus' name? How many believe this morning they are moving from the level where they are to a new level? You know, I can't tell you. I told you I'm used to not a very quiet church. How many believe we are moving from the level we are to a new level? How many believe their businesses cannot remain in the same level? How many believe their families cannot remain in the same level? Come on, shout, I am going to overtake this morning. Come on, shout like you believe that I am going to overtake this morning. As our bishop said from Wednesday, oh, and to them that were not able to come on Wednesday, but don't you worry, because you are going to receive everything that you missed from Wednesday in Jesus' name. Now, where we read in the portion of scripture that we read, the Bible talks about a man called Elijah. And the Bible says that this man called Elijah, for 3.5 years, he said, it is not going to rain. Oh, and to them, by the way, that never made it to come, because our bishop was talking about knowing what you carry in the inside of you. And can I submit to you this morning that what you carry is not local, but what you carry is international? Look at the way you're looking at me. I said, what you carry is not local, but what you carry is for generations and generations and generations and generations to come. You better understand what is in the inside of you, because every time you understand what is in the inside of you, the Bible says that they that know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploits. There is something about knowing who you are. There is something about knowing what you carry. The Bible says we are in this world, but we are not of this world. Look at you, that is why you're not saying amen, because you're not getting what I'm saying. The Bible says we are in this world, but we are not of this world. In other words, we have something bigger in the inside of us. There is something special about us. We are not ordinary people. The Bible says we are a chosen generation. And I am here to submit to you, indeed you are a chosen generation. I said you are a chosen generation. You are a peculiar person in the eyes of God. And so the Bible says, Elijah said, in the next 3.5 years, it is not going to rain. And according to his word, it did rain. But look at this. The Bible says, he went, I know you know the story very well, and he killed the prophets of Baal. And after killing the prophets of Baal, he tells Ahab to go eat and drink. Now look at this. He tells Ahab, go eat and drink, but he goes up the mountain. There is something about going to the mountain that does not leave you the same.
Right.
Yeah. I say there is something about going up the mountain that does not leave you the same. I thank God, because I was here yesterday when we were opening the fast. And can I submit to you that every time God gives you victory, it is not a time for you to rest, but it is a time for you to push more and more and more and more. After we finish our 21 days, thank God, Bishop, we are going for 40. After we finish our 40 days, it is not a time to say, hey, hiyo maombi nimeomba. Ninajua itanifikisha December. Hapana. But it is a time to push another gear and push and push and push and push in Jesus' name. Don't be that kind of a person who will make a prayer for your breakfast from January and you finish everything in December. Ati tumeombea hiyo maombi yote, sasa hiyo sasa itatufikisha mpaka December. Hapana. After God gives you victory, it is not a time to rest. Look at this. Elijah has killed the prophet of Baal, but he understands it is not a time to go and sleep, because the Bible sensitive and to allow ourselves to go for more and more and more. So he tells this man, you go eat and drink, but I am going to the mountain. In other words, he is telling Ahab, I know you operate in the food of this world. You love eating. But me, I am going to eat some other food that gives me strength and power. Let me submit to you this morning that the strength of a Christian does not come from mokimo or ugali. let me say that again. The strength of any Christian does not come from the mokimo and the ugali you eat. In other words, let me simplify it and bring it home. Spiritual muscles. See, you have physical muscles. Now, spiritual muscles cannot be built by physical food.
Amen.
Let me say that again so at least you give me a better amen. Spiritual muscles cannot be built by physical food.
Amen.
If you want to conquer in the spiritual world, you better become a spiritual man. If you want to get victory after victory, you better learn how to build your spiritual muscles very well. He tells this man, you go eat and drink. Me, I know you. I know you like food. I know you like eating okimo and feasting. But me, I am going up the mountain. And look at this. The man goes, and the Bible says that he puts his head between the knees. And he begins to pray. This other man called Ahab has gone, and he has started feasting, and he has started doing everything he knows. He has started eating nyama choma. He has started eating what. But this one, there's something different about this man. Because he goes and puts his head between his knees. Now look at this. When he was saying that it is not going to rain, he only declared, in other words, he said, by the way, for the next 3.5 years, it is not going to rain. But for him to call the rain back, he has to labor. For him to say it is not going to rain, it's not a hard thing. Just the same way we come and we are prophesying here and you're just saying, Bishop prophesy here. Sidi huyu naongea juu yake. Sidi huyu. And Bishop the other day was talking about taking the word and believing it and making it your own. By the way, the reason you come for the service, it's not just to warm the seat. It is for you to hear what God is saying.
Amen.
You better become a person that can hear the word and run with it.
Amen.
Because the word that you do not believe in cannot work for you. I say the word that you do not believe in cannot work for you. So you better teach yourself to receive the word and say, this one is not for Kamau, this one belongs to me. This one is not for so and so, this is my word. Have you ever had people, even when they come for the service and the preacher is preaching and they are telling themselves, hii ni lazima iwe, kai, bona hakukuja kwa service. Why did she come for the service? This one was hers. If she did not come, it is your word. Pick it. Wengine when the preacher is preaching, na unasikia ni kama unamaku, unasema, iyo najua. I wish mama so and so was here. Because I know, yes, it is your word. Pick it. And correct where God wants you to correct your ways. So this man, he has to labor for it to come back. The kingdom of God is about people that are willing to labor.
Amen.
It's not about those people who want to get things chop, one touch. But it is about the people that are willing to get into the presence of God.
Amen.
They are ready to wait on God.
Yes.
Come rain, come sunshine. They are ready to tarry in the presence of God and wait. May you be among the people that will be found in the presence of God. I said, may you be among the people that will be found waiting in the presence of God. So he has to labor. And the Bible says he went with a servant called Gehazi. And the Bible says he begins to pray for the first time and there is nothing. And can I submit to you, by the way, you better begin to pray with people that believe in the God you believe in.
Right.
I said you better begin to pray with people that believe in Before you begin to pray, you know, as Christians, we have a tendency of giving people our burdens. Hey, Mama so-and-so, hey, I want you to stand with me. And they tell you, hey, me, I'm going to stand with you. But you do not know, by the way, whether after they say they are believing in you, whether they will pray or not. I have a man of God, friend of mine. He told me, every time you call me and you tell me to pray for you, make sure I pray for you on the phone. Because if I tell you I will pray for you, you better be sure by the time I'm finishing that call, I have forgotten. So please make sure that I prayed for you the moment you say that I pray for you. So begin to pray with people that believe what you carry in the inside of you. People that believe in the God that you believe in. People that believe, yes, I know this one can go far. People that know, yes, I know what this one carries. Not people who tell you with the lips, yes, I'm going to pray for you. But after 2 days, they have forgotten and they have eaten and everything else is going on in their lives, but they have forgotten you. So this man tells Gehazi, I want you to go and check whether there is something coming up. And the man of God is praying and praying. And Gehazi goes out. And he comes back and tells the man of God, I did not see anything. And Elijah says, I want you to go the second time. And I want you to check whether there is anything. I keep saying, if I was in the shoes of that man, at least I would have come and encouraged the man of God and say, by the way, I did not see anything, but let's keep praying. But I want to believe this man was just there to be sent. Go and check. And he goes. And he comes back. Then he's told, go back and check again. Then he goes and comes back. And he says, I did not see anything. Hata kama ni hile haku encourage mtu wa Mungu wa mwampie. Kuna kitu tu wa mkalao ninaona. Hata kama si macho ya kimwini. Kuna vile tu ninaona. Kwa macho ya kiroho kuna kitu inatokea. Hasemi hivyo. Yeye anaingia tu anasema, oi, 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 oi. Hakuna kitu nimeona. Anaambiwa mara nne, ingia tu waangalie. Anaingia anasema, oi, ananeenda wadho kafio.
I don't know who has the ID. I'm not going to check the ears. I'm only going to show you something. the idea. I think I have a painting there. So she decides. Most of the people don't want to keep their ideas. I don't know why. Thank you. So the lady decides, because this man is not coming for, I am going to have a conversation with God today. We are going to sort it out. So she goes and closes herself in those, I don't know what they are called, in a closet. That one. And she says, now God, you better come, we need to talk. You better come. And she behaves like God is there, and it's okay, by the way. Then this is how she began her prayer. Lord, how many years are this? Let me say it the way she said it. And she's counting and counting and counting for God. And counting. Most of the times we want to see things there and then. But believe me, you, even if you don't see it there and then, something is forming in the spiritual realm. I believe she had even started counting for God. 1, 2, 3. I've not seen anything. 1, 2, 3. They will make it happen. She's not seeing anything. Most of the times we want to see things, but we forget that something is happening in the spiritual. So you, even if you don't see something tangible, believe that something is happening in the spiritual. Even if you don't see that car right now, believe that it is coming home. Even if you do not see profit in your business right away, believe that something is happening in the spiritual realm. Amen. Why you shout a better amen. Amen? Even if you don't see it now, I want to prophesy it shall come forth in Jesus' name. Amen. I said I want to prophesy it shall come forth in Jesus' name. Amen. So the man prays, and the seventh time the Bible says something began to fall. And the Bible says that Elijah told this servant called Gehazi, I want you to go and tell Ahab to go up before the rain stops him. And the Bible says, where we read in verse number 46, if I could get that scripture very fast, where we read in verse number 46, then the power of God came upon Elijah, and tackling his cloak into his belt, he ran ahead of Ahab. In other words, he told this man, I want you to enter into your chariot before the rain stops you. But the Bible says there is something extra that happened to this man. And the Bible says the power of God came upon Elijah and he outran Ahab. Hear me well this morning in the name of Jesus. I am here to declare to somebody, because of waiting on the Lord on 21 days, I am here to declare an anointing for you to overtake is coming in Jesus' name. I say that an anointing for you to overtake is coming. You better begin to overtake anybody that has gone ahead of you. Do I have a believing church this morning? Begin to overtake everyone that has gone ahead of you. By the way, ever begin to thank God for those that went ahead of you. Because this morning, an overtaking anointing is coming upon you. The power of the Lord is going to come upon you. You shall overtake them. You shall run ahead of them. You shall go ahead of them in the name of Jesus. And hear me well this morning. By the way, let me tell you, the overtaking anointing does not consider who had gone ahead of you. You did not hear that very well. Overtaking anointing does not consider who had gone ahead of you. Could be there are people that went ahead of you, but I'm here to declare you shall go ahead of them. You shall overtake them in the name of overtaking anointing does not consider who had gone ahead of you. All you need to do, by the way, all you need to do this morning is to focus on God. I see most of the times, I'm not a very bad driver, but I see anytime you want to overtake, there are a few things.
one of the things you must do is that you must check whether there is somebody who is coming in front of you. If there is nobody who is coming ahead of you, the next thing that you do, what do you begin to do? What do you begin to do? Now, some of you that are in this service, you need to begin to give that indicator. I say you need to begin to give that indicator. Some of you that are here, you need to start indicating, I want to do something. Every time you remove that indicator, you're saying, there's something I want to do. There is somewhere I am going. Some of you that are seated here today, begin to tiam. Begin to indicate because there is somewhere you are going. And how many believe they have a destiny in God? And how many believe they must get to their destiny? How many believe whether the devil likes it or likes it, they will still get to their destiny? Come on, shout, I am beginning to indicate. If I were you, I would stand up on my feet and begin to do this. How many believe they are beginning to indicate? They are beginning to say, yes, I am coming. You have gone ahead of me, but I am beginning to indicate. You know the things of God, by the way, they are for those people who want to do some silly things and some stupid things. Now begin to indicate like you mean it. Now listen, when you indicate, by the way, you do not put your pedal on the brakes. You remove your pedal from the brakes and put your foot on the accelerator. Now begin to do that.
You shall be the head and never the tail. You shall be above and never below.
believe it, shout, God is my portion. Come on, if you believe it, shout, God is my portion. If you believe it, shout, God is my portion. Lift up your heads and begin to receive it this morning. Lift up your voice and begin to receive it. Begin to receive it. Begin to receive it.
Come on, somebody shout, yeah. We declare it broken in the name of Jesus. And God gives you a supernatural speed. What others did in 4 days, you will do it in 4 seconds. What others did in 4 months, you will do it in 4 days. What others did in many years, you will do in a couple of years. Somebody shout, yes! Hallelujah. Are you here this morning? And you have never received Jesus, and he wants to give you a supernatural speed in your life so that you can begin to reorganize certain things. If you're here, every head bowed, every eye closed, please quickly lift up that hand. I want to pray for you. If you don't know Jesus as Lord and Savior, this is the day of salvation. Today is the day, not tomorrow. Not tomorrow, it's when you're hearing the word. Are you here? Lift up that hand. I want to see it. I want to see it. Somebody, God bless your people in Jesus' name. Amen. Appreciate the minister this morning. Come on, wait.